All right, thank you very much. Well, have you had the jitters about the stock market after the last couple of weeks? A lot of people have, and Stuart Welch is our financial expert here on Money Tuesday. Hi, how are you?
Hey, Janice.
I've been watching it, So where do we stand this morning?
Well, right now I looked at the futures just as I walked into the studio. It's down 2%.
2%.
So it's going to open up kind of crazy, and I guess it's going to be another crazy day.
All right, so when you're looking at that, though, and for the, there are a lot of people like yourself or others who follow the stock market consistently, perhaps for their investors, but for a lot of folks, they just have a 401k that is invested. You may not look at it all the time or watch it. So what's going on for those folks?
Well, typically they're going to be in their 401k, they're going to be in mutual funds.
Mm-hmm.
And typically those mutual funds, at least some of the mutual funds, are going to be have stocks in them. So what happens is market's down, they're continuing to add money from paycheck to paycheck, right, into that. That's actually a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds kind of like, oh no, I should be out, but it's actually a good thing because they're buying more shares at lower prices. And particularly for people that are in a 401k and they've got a long time before they're going to have to tap that.
Yeah, as long as you don't have to check, cash it out.
As long as you're not going to have to tap it, this, you know, this is a good thing.
Okay.
This is something that you might actually look forward to. It's very counterintuitive.
Because when the market starts going back up, you've bought more shares, you're going to have more money.
Yeah, you're going to have more money.
Okay, let's talk about China and kind of put it in perspective of what that has meant to the investor.
Well, right now, the China's on a big roller coaster. So the China's fastest growing economy in the world. But what they've seen is that its growth rate is beginning to slow. It's still the fastest growing economy. And so that has, and it's the second largest economy.
Mm-hmm.
So it has impact. When you cross over and look at what's going on in the U.S., the U.S. economy actually looks pretty good. Still a little anemic, but it has positive growth. Literally all the signs are positive. You've got positive in housing, interest rates remain low, the economy is still percolating, jobs are good. It's not great, but they're good, so everything's positive here. China's been really the big story. The other big story is interest rates. There's a lot of uncertainty around what the Fed's gonna do with interest rates. They meet in September. There's a lot of speculation, and they've indicated that they're gonna raise rates this year, likely in September. My bet is that they probably will raise rates 0.25%.
Why does that happen in an economy like this?
Well, what they're concerned about is, one of the things they're concerned about is inflation. And they don't want the economy to heat up too fast, and interest rates will help hold that down. If you're a business owner borrowing money, then you're looking at your borrowing costs going up, so you're a little nervous about that. But I think that the economy in the U.S. is doing well enough to sustain that. And the question really is not the 0.25%. The question is, what's the Fed going to do after that? Are they going to raise rates rapidly after that, which I don't believe they do.
Because we're still at historical lows, right?
You're still at historical lows. Inflation is really low. Yellen, the Fed chairman, has indicated she's going to take a very conservative stance. So I think, you know, it's much ado about nothing, but that could last a while. So you could see this go on, this kind of thing going in the stock market for the next month or two.
We've really enjoyed gas prices going down.
Yeah.
That's also an indicator, though, of what's going on in the world economy, too, right?
It is. It's probably the third leg of that stool. Oil prices have gone from $100 to under $50 a barrel. And that has been bad for the oil sector, for the energy sector. You've seen their stocks get crushed. But it's been really good for the consumer, and the consumer is going to take that money. It's like a pay raise.
Sure.
They're going to take money, and they're going to turn around and put it back into the economy. They're 70% of the action, so that's probably good for the economy. That helps boost the economy.
Okay, so if you've been nervous, bottom line, settle down and let this ride.
Yeah,
okay.
This is, if you've got time, the market always recovers 100% of the time.
All right, I'm going to go with that. All right, Stuart Welch.
Thanks, Janice.
Thanks so much.